আচ্ছা, বিফোর আই স্টার্ট মাই টুডে সেশন, লেট মি টেল ইউ অ্যাবাউট সামথিং সামথিং অ্যাবাউট এক্সেল শিট। টুডে অ্যাকচুয়ালি উই আর গ্র্যাজুয়ালি মুভিং টুয়ার্ডস দ্য পার্ট অফ অ্যাপ্লাইড স্ট্যাটিস্টিক্স। উই শ্যাল বি লার্নিং এ ফিউ অফ ইটস অ্যাপ্লিকেশনস। দ্য ডে হ্যাজ অলরেডি কাম অ্যান্ড উই আর ইকুইপড উইথ লটস অফ টুলস। উই আর গোয়িং টু স্টার্ট দ্য অ্যাপ্লিকেশনস, বাট বিফোর দ্যাট আই মাস্ট টেল ইউ ওয়ান থিং। If you are using your desktop or laptop, okay, then only you can perform this operation which I'm going to show. If not, no problem, because I'm not going to do any calculations in the portal of Excel today, but I'm going to show you something which you, when you find time, you do this and prepare your Excel sheet accordingly. Okay, for our later subsequent classes, not for today's class, but you have to do a kind of the thing with your Excel sheet. And if it is already there in your Excel sheet, then it's okay, no problem. So I what I am telling you right now, you if you do not have your desktop and laptop in front of you, if you are using your mobile phone, you take a copy and you write the steps only, steps which you need to do when you will be the desktop and laptop will be available to you. Okay, so you just write the steps. You will first open an Excel sheet, okay, and then you will go to this part. I hope that you are able to see what I'm showing to you. You'll go to this part, and from there you see here is a thing which is called Excel options. So your next step will be to click on this button, Excel options. Okay, so you just click on Excel options. Let me click it. If I click Excel option, you see this particular window is opening. Can you see this window? This is opening here, you see? And in this window, here you can find several buttons over here, like popular, formulas, proofing, save, advanced, customize, add-ins, okay? So you just click on add-ins. Let me select add-ins and okay, put okay. And just a minute. Excel options and then add-ins. If you click on add-ins, this window will come. Okay, if you click on add-ins, this window will come. You see here it is shown analysis tool pack, analysis tool pack VVA, like this. Many things are there. So you can select analysis tool pack VVA. Analysis tool after add-ins, inside add-ins, you select analysis tool pack VVA. And you click on this button, go. If you click on the button go, this particular window will open. Here you see I have already selected these things, okay? Analysis tool pack VVA, conditional sum wizard, solver add-in, everything I have selected. And if you put on okay, then what will happen after you click okay, close it, and then you will be able to find in the data section something like this, data analysis. This particular thing will be shown in your Excel. If you are using your desktop, right now, and if you open an Excel sheet, and if you go to this part, data part, probably if it is not, this particular operation hasn't been performed earlier in your Excel sheet, probably this particular button will not be shown to you. Data analysis part will not be there. Solver part will not be there. I think. But if you are actually using the higher versions of Excel, then probably these are inbuilt. You don't have to perform any operations. But my Excel version is a lower version, and therefore I need to do the operations, which I have shown you just now. I am again showing this to you. First of all, I shall click on it. Then I will go to Excel options. This window will open. Here I will select add-ins. If I select add-ins, if I click on it once, this window will open. And then I have to select this analysis tool pack VVA. I will click on go. This will come. And then I have to click on OK. And once I do this, this data analysis tool pack will be activated. And with the data analysis tool pack, we can do lots of statistical operations. I'm not going to show you today, but I am actually preparing you for the later subsequent classes, so that when I shall be discussing these in Excel sheet, it would be much better if you use your desktop or laptop to do the operations. And if you are unable to follow me in today's class, don't worry. The steps I shall write in a particular, I shall paste all the steps in a Word file, and I will post it in the Google Classroom so that all of you can follow it. Okay, so don't worry. So I am going to start my today's session with the topic, one of the important topics and one of the fundamental topics of applied statistics, which is called, as you can see, I have written correlation, and it is also known as, sometimes it is known as product movement correlation or Carl Pearson's correlation. Carl Pearson is the name of the statistician who actually developed the idea of correlation, and therefore by his name, this name has been set. And product movement correlation is actually used because in the tool, in the statistical formula, this product movement, this quantity, this entity will be used. Okay, so I hope that you have already used seen my video of product movement. Okay, I actually posted it in the YouTube. If you have not done it, then you please, before starting this particular note, you just go through once my video of product movement, because one of the special case of that has been used over here. Okay, so therefore it is known as product movement correlation coefficient, or sometimes it is known as Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient. You will find it very interesting because, see, students, I tell you that the pure statistical part has actually been done by all of us. I am actually sure today I'm going to start the applied statistics portion, and from henceforth we shall be dealing with the applied statistics statistical problem in all of our subsequent classes. So you be very careful, because that is actually what you need to do with your statistical analysis. Now, in correlation, what we actually do is that we consider a pair of random variables. And you know, if when we consider a pair of random variables together simultaneously, that actually corresponds to a distribution which is called bivariate distribution. Bi means two, a variable, variate means variable. So a bivariate distribution is consisting of two variables, capital X and capital Y. Now the question is, if we have the variable capital X and capital Y, we need to find a sort of association between the two variables. For example, I need to find that if one variable changes, whether the other variable also changes, and if it changes, in what direction. Say, for example, I can cite one example, a very good example of that. Say, for example, price and demand. When war comes, or war happens, or there are some calamities, natural calamities, or in our current situation, COVID-19 situation, what we are seeing that the usual prices of the commodities have been increased. Okay, so when the price increases, we actually try not to buy the items. Okay, suppose nowadays the price of Hilsa fish is actually running by the quantity of rupees 1900 per kilo. Okay, and this you know that 4520 quintals of Hilsa fish is coming actually from is coming from Bangladesh and has already reached the Howrah market. Okay, now the price has reduced. The quantity is huge, the price has reduced. Okay, so this quantity amount available for feeding us is inversely proportional to the price. Price is inversely proportional to the demand. When price increases, demand decreases. Okay, if you are doing a job where your salary is, per month salary is, say, for 20,000, okay, then always you will try to buy items, your daily items, from a nearby grocer's shop. But if you are actually getting a salary, a fair amount of salary, like for 80,000 or 90,000, you will not be, because of the prestige issue, you will not go to the nearby grocer's shop, and you will always try to get into a shopping mall, Spencer's, etc., and you will try to buy from them. So when income of a person increases, their expenditure also increases. And it happens, it is the human nature. So you see, if I consider this price and demand together, if we consider the income and expenditure together, if we consider the quantity available for feed us and the price together, these can be considered to be the real life bivariate distribution. And we always can find the association between them. We can find an association between the amount available with price. We can find the association between price and demand. We can find the association between income and expenditure. Can we find the association between beauty and intelligence? Think. Okay. Anyways, now these pair of variables where association can be found, these pair of variables are called quantifiable variables. Means here the kind of association available is quantifiable. And the question is how to quantify them. How to quantify these variables? The answer lies in the topic of correlation. The tool which we use to quantify the association between the two variables is called the correlation coefficient between the two variables, or sometimes it is called product movement correlation coefficient or Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient, because Carl Pearson developed this particular tool. So if we have a bivariate distribution capital X and capital Y, correlation coefficient between them is denoted by R of capital X comma Y, or it is denoted by R suffix capital X into Y. These are the notations. And it is defined in the following way. You see, in the numerator, we have written a summation. Double summation will not be written, because this summation, single summation will be written, because first of all, for each of these variables, I, we will calculate the term xi minus x bar and yi minus y bar, and we'll multiply them together and we'll take the sum of that. So summation I goes from 1 to n xi minus x bar yi minus y bar, and divided by under square root sign, summation I goes from 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square, under square root sign, summation I goes from 1 to n yi minus y bar whole square. You can ask me one question. You can ask me that in the previous classes, you have seen that whenever I discussed about two variables together, always double summation were used. It was because the number of variables present for X, number of items present for capital X and number of items present for capital Y were different. Maybe same, but can also be different. But correlation in terms of, if we talk about correlation, then we have to keep in mind that the number of items present in capital X and number of items present in capital Y, they must be same. If number of items present in capital X is not same as number of items present in capital Y, correlation coefficient cannot be found out. So I is the quantifier. It's the indicator which indicates the number of variables present in both these. And therefore, since I is same for capital X and capital Y, so single summation has been used. So do not get confused. Do not think that this is a printing mistake. Okay, because since the variables are same, number of items present in the variables are same, single summation has been used. Now, this is the definition of correlation. This is the formula of correlation, but this is not the computational formula. For easy going, we actually use the following formula, which I have written over here. This formula is used, and that is the computational formula for correlation. This computational formula is very easy to find. If you break this product into parts, okay, and if you apply summation on both the parts, this can be proved is very easy. You can do it by yourself. Don't have to, this is not a very tough job for you. You are already well equipped with that. So from this, I can derive this particular formula. So for doing the calculation, we shall be using this formula, and this is known as our computational formula. And also, if I talk about this formula, the original one, and you see what I have done over here, in the original formula, what I have done is that I have multiplied both the halves, here also, my note is always prone to printing mistakes. So here somehow a one has been spotted. Okay, this one should not be there. Okay, don't worry. This is my fault. So what I have done that in both the numerators and denominators, I have multiplied by 1 by n. Okay, so you see, if I consider 1 by n, 1 by n can be written as 1 by root n into 1 by root n. So 1 by root n, 1 n can be associated with a summation xi minus x bar whole square. Another 1 by n can be associated with summation yi minus y bar whole square. So if we consider this to be constants, some 1 by under square root sign 1 by root n multiplied by under square root sign 1 by root n will give you 1 by n, and that 1 by n, that 1 by n will cancel each other. So that will remain same. If you have gone through my note of my video of product moment correlation coefficient, even if you have seen this particular, if you can recall the formula of that, you will find that this formula is nothing but the formula which can be written in the term of expectation as this. This is nothing but expectation of capital X minus EX multiplied by Y minus capital Y minus expectation of Y. And the remaining, the under square root sign, this particular term of X with respect to X can be written as VX. So under square root sign VX, under square root sign VY. And you know the square root of VX is the standard deviation of X, and square root of VY is the standard deviation of Y. And E of X minus EX, Y minus EY is nothing but the formula of covariance of XY. Covariance is a special case of product moment correlation coefficient, product moment for R equals to 1 and S equal to 1, product moment about origin. So covariance of XY by sigma X into sigma Y is the definition of RXY. And when covariance, if two variables, when covariance between the two variables are zero, correlation coefficient between the two variables will be zero. Okay, variances or standard deviation of the two variables can never be zero because it measures distance. Or it can be zero, but it cannot be negative. But if the variance is here, variance cannot be zero, because if variances are zero for the two variables, then this definition will collapse, because in the denominator zero will come, and which is undefined. Division by zero is undefined. That is another version of the correlation coefficient. Now here is a problem which I have selected from the exercise. The problem is saying the following is a sampling of 10 recently released first time federal prisoners. The data given give their crime, their sentence, and the actual time that they served. So here is the serial number. Okay, so how many items are present for both capital X and capital Y? If I treat this as capital X, this as capital X, and this as capital Y, then number of items present in both these columns are same. That is from 1 to 10. What are the crimes which have been considered? Drug abuse, forgery, kidnapping, income tax, drug abuse, embezzlement, robbery. These are the crimes which have been. And what this particular table is showing us, that the criminal number 1 is sentenced for 4 months for drug abuse. And after 24 months, because of some reason, he has been released. Maybe due to lack of evidence, or maybe his performance in the correctional home is very good. Okay, so, or maybe he has got some kind of mercy letter like this. So he has served, he got the sentence for 44 months, but he served 24 months. He was the criminal for drug abuse. The second criminal was actually sentenced for 30 months for forgery, and he served 12 months for the crime. And in this way, this data has been produced. Okay, all these criminals have been released by the first-time federal prisoners. And these are first-time federal prisoners, and they have been recently released. Now, draw a scatter diagram or diagram of dots. Scatter diagram means diagram of dots. So in scatter diagram, what happens? We put the variable X, we consider one of the variable as X and another variable as Y. We plot, we take two axes, capital X and capital Y, and we plot the figures. So a diagram of dots are actually obtained. These dots are not joined by freehand curve or like that, or scale. We just keep the dots as they are. Okay, here is a important thing, is that there is no hard and fast rule whether I have to take the first column to be capital X and the second column to be capital Y. You can interchange. You can consider the first column to be this column to be capital X and that column to be capital Y also. So that is not a big issue which variable you are treating as capital X and which variable you are treating as capital Y. These are only names. Okay. We are supposed to plot the figure diagram of dots, scatter diagram of the sentence time versus time actually served. It has already mentioned. Compute the sample correlation coefficient. Sample correlation coefficient means, since we are dealing with not all the criminals, but a sample of that. So therefore it is called sample correlation coefficient. What does this say about the relationship between the length of a sentence and the time actually served? So we have plotted the figure, we have plotted here, okay? And I have done this with the help of Excel, Microsoft Excel. And in Microsoft Excel, easily we can find the scatter diagrams. I will show you how to do it in another class, not today. In that class, where only Excels and the operations by Excel will be shown to you. If I do it right now, then I shall not be getting the time to continue. Okay. With this particular note. So if I plot, you see a diagram of dots have been some dots. Okay, these dots are actually time served months, which is capital Y, has been obtained. And this particular dots has a kind of tendency to move upward. Okay, so you can imagine a kind of line passing through all the dots. Okay, and this line will go like that. Okay, a kind of imaginary line, you think. Will pass through this set of dots. Some of the points will fall into the line and some of the points will be above and below the line. Okay, so there will be kind of thing. Okay, so this line is a line of approximation. We shall not discuss about the line right now because that is another chapter. So you can see, any layman can see that this particular thing, association, has a kind of tendency of moving upwards, a kind of linear tendency of moving upwards. Okay, so what is the amount of association between them? Let us stick to the correlation coefficient for the today's class only. So I have prepared the chart. I shall not discuss in details how to prepare. You already know that how to prepare the chart. I have put the numbers, serial numbers over here. Crimes have been shown. Capital X are sentenced in months. Capital Y are time served in months. And because of the formula, in the formula, we need capital XY. You already know that summation XY is needed. Let me show you once again. Summation XY is needed. Summation X square is needed. Summation Y square is needed. So by looking into the formula, accordingly, we have selected our columns. Okay, so we have introduced the column XY, X square, and capital Y square. You don't have to write suffixes. Okay, these are actually automatically implied. In bracket, I have actually transformed the months in terms of years. But during the calculation, I have not used the years. I have used the months. Okay, as the data is given, I have used the data accordingly. These blue colored things are years because we always talk about years, and it is easy to identify 3.66 years than to identify 44 months. If I suddenly ask you, I have got a sentence for 74 months, then you have to scratch your head. Okay, so my brain is actually has got a kind of setting like that. We easily understand the year. Okay, so just to make you understand, I have shown you what these months actually represent in terms of years. So these values have not been used in the calculation. So after putting all the values, I have calculated the product of the two variables, capital X and capital Y. I have written the products. I have written capital X square. I have written capital Y square. I have calculated everything, and their respective summations have been considered. Their respective summations have also been considered. And the arithmetic mean between the two of the items of capital X and capital Y have also been calculated. So suppose while doing the calculation, this item is missing. okay, this item is missing, is not given to you, then you cannot find the correlation coefficient between, because if the item is missing, then this value will be treated as zero. Okay, so for correlation coefficient, number of items present in both the variables must be same. That is one of the important conditions, and you have to remember this particular thing. So I have calculated means, okay, and after calculation of calculating all of these things, I have put the values over here. I have put the values over here, all the values, and you see, we have got the result, approximately 0.9921. This is the result we have obtained. 0.9921 is the result, okay, RXY. So 0.9921 is very high value, is a high value, and we'll say that since the value is so high and positive, so there is a strong positive relation between the two variables, sentence and time served. Okay, and we'll say that means what? That means that if the sentence in months is linearly increasing, the time served is also linearly increasing. Okay, so we have calculated this. Now we have calculated the correlation coefficient between the two variables. Association has been quantified, but the question is, just like we calculate the probability and we know the probability is lower value, lowest value is zero and its highest value is one. So if I do not say this particular theorem to a particular layman which is new to probability, he can do a wrong calculation and he can get absurd results. Suppose his calculation is wrong and he has got results like 2.33 from probability, he will not understand whether he has done a mistake. Whenever I am saying to him that, okay, probability's lower limit is zero and its upper limit is one, then he knows that he has to be very careful, because values of probabilities lesser than zero and greater than one are absurd. Just like that, you need to know what are the upper and lower limits of the correlation coefficient, because this correlation coefficient is also bounded. So we need to know the upper and lower limit. So here is the theorem, it's very important theorem. It says that the correlation coefficient between the two variables lie between minus one and plus one. So lower limit of the correlation coefficient is minus one and the upper limit is plus one. I have proved this particular result here. It's very simple to prove, easy to prove, because you already know the mechanical applications of expectations. So I'm quickly showing you. Let capital X and capital Y be two variables whose expectation of capital X is given by mu X and expectation of capital Y is given by mu Y. So I am considering this term. You see, X minus mu X by sigma X plus minus Y minus mu Y by sigma Y. If I consider these two terms, whether I consider plus or minus sign in between, okay, their squares expectation will always be a positive, non-negative. Now, if I break the square with the help of the formula a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square, so this will be a square plus b square minus or plus 2ab. So I have written it like that. Now I am applying the expectation on both the parts. Now this sigma x, you already know the sigma x is constant, variance of the item is constant, it can be taken outside and it will be outside the expectation sign, but since the square symbol is there, so it will get squared. Similarly, sigma y will come outside the expectation sign as sigma y squared. Sigma x and sigma y will remain same. Now you see that expectation of x minus mu x whole square, the average of the square of the deviations from the of the values from the mean, is nothing but the variance itself. So this formula is sigma x square itself. This formula is sigma y square itself. And the above formula is the product moment or covariance between the two variables, capital X and capital Y. Okay, so we have put all these here. Sigma x square will cancel each other. Sigma y square will cancel each other. And we are getting 1 plus 1 plus minus 2. Covariance of XY by sigma x, sigma y will be R of XY. So we can take two common, we'll write 2 into 1 plus minus r into capital X comma y. 2 cannot be 0, so we can write here from 2 is either positive or 2 cannot be 0, it can be positive. But from here with this equation, I can divide both the sides by 2. I can write 1 plus minus r x y greater than or equal to 0. So here two, from this I'm getting two different things. One is 1 plus rxy is greater than or equal to 0, and 1 minus rxy greater than or equal to 0. From these two inequalities, I'm actually getting rxy is greater than or equal to minus 1 and rxy is less than or equal to plus 1. So see how easy it is. And we know that this is, if this is the limit of the correlation coefficient, if this is the lower limit and that is the upper limit, so whenever if I go back to my problem which I have discussed just now, you see 0.9921 is very near to 1. Therefore I have mentioned here that in between the sentence obtained and the time served of the criminals, the correlation between them is very strong. Very strong positive correlation is between them. So it's a very important note over here. If during the calculation for a particular set of problems, if you find that the correlation between them is coming out to be 1, we'll say that the variable has perfect positive correlation between them. If the correlation between the two variables is -1, we'll say that it is perfect negative correlation. And if the correlation is coming between the two variables as 0, we'll call it as perfect. We call that there is no correlation between the two variables. Here I have shown a few examples. In example 1, I have given you this. You see, 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 2 is 4, 3 plus 2 is 5, 4 plus 2 is 6, 5 plus 2 is 7. For this particular example, a linear kind of relationship is there present between capital X and capital Y, but it is not exactly linear. If I consider an imaginary straight line passing through the points, all the points will not lie on the particular straight line. Okay, so the correlation, the association has come out to be 0.9863, but it is not exactly 1. For the second example, you see, I have considered this 1 0 2 1 3 2 4 3 5 4. Here a kind of relationship has been obtained. It is exactly linear. So correlation, after calculating the correlation, I have got 1. Correlation coefficient between these two set of variables, capital X prime and Y prime, is 1. Similarly, if I consider this, you see the value of the X is increasing and Y is decreasing. So a kind of downward tendency is there, a kind of downward tendency in the fourth quadrant. Okay, because all the values of Y's are negative. All the values of capital X is positive. So the values are in the negative quadrant. Be it in the negative quadrant, no problem. It can be in negative quadrant, positives, it can be in positive quadrant, but its tendency is linear and correlation has come out to be -1. Okay, so these results justify that when there is a perfect positive correlation, I will say that between the variables capital X prime and Y prime, there is a perfect positive correlation, and between the variables X double prime and Y double prime, there is a perfect negative correlation. Now you see, whenever we say that the two variables are independent, then correlation between them is 0. Two variables are independent, they are uncorrelated. How can I prove it? Very easy. If we consider two variables, capital X and capital Y, and if these variables are independent, expectation of capital X into Y can be written as expectation of X into expectation of Y. And by using this, covariance of X, Y can be written as E of, by definition, it is E of X minus EX, Y minus EY. Multiply these two, you will get, this can be expressed as E of X, Y minus EX into EY. This particular calculation has already been shown in the previous class. Now, since these variables are independent, E of X, Y is EX into EY, so I can write it as EX into EY. EX into EY is already present over here. This will cancel each other. Correlation, covariance is 0, and since covariance is 0, correlation coefficient will also be 0 because numerator is 0. Case 1 is solved. For case 2, I am considering this example, X and Y. Carefully look into the example. All the values of X's have been squared in Y. So actually we had the relation Y equal to X squared. Okay, see we have -3 whole square 9, -2 whole square 4, -1 whole square 1, 1 square 1, 2 square 4, and 3 square 9. So to calculate the correlation between the two variables, I have calculated everything, xy, x square, y square, everything. And you see that I have highlighted here that summation x is 0 and summation xy is 0. And therefore, by putting all these things, whatever be the value of the denominator is, since since summation x is zero, x bar is zero, arithmetic mean is zero, so this part vanishes. Since summation xy is zero, this part vanishes. So correlation between the two variables is actually zero. We have already known from the note above that if the correlation between the two variables is zero, we say that there is no association between the two variables. Now let me explicitly tell you what it actually means. When the correlation between the two variables is zero, it means that there is no linear relationship between the two variables. Okay. If correlation coefficient between the two variables is zero, there is no linear relationship between the two variables, but non-linear relationship may be present. And it is indeed present, you see, because all the values of the y's x's have been squared to get the value of y. So correlation between the two variables is zero. Zero implies that the variables are not linearly connected, but they may be non-linearly connected. And this is justified by the following curve. You see, I have plotted here this equation, y equal to x square, corresponding to the values given. And you see, a kind of parabola is present. Here, the correlation between the two variables is zero. It means that the two variables, capital X and capital Y, they are not linearly connected, but they may be non-linearly connected. All these operations, which I have shown you in this particular class, all these operations can be done using Excel. Let me proceed a bit further with the chapter of correlation. Okay, and then I shall take a class on Excel and I will show you how to perform all these operations using Excel. You will find it very interesting. But before that, you do this preliminary prerequisite performance with your Excel sheet, get the data analysis pack, and then I'll show you in one of the subsequent classes. Okay, and before uploading today's note, I will also upload a separate note where I'll show how to do the performance in the Excel to get the data analysis back. So you see you in the next class. This is for today. Tata.